Hi, today I'm going to say about pendulums and how to measure the exact depth. There may be difference 2 or 3 feet difference, but you can measure the exact depth using this pendulums, and you can also find or locate exact water spots. Okay, this is a pendulum which was used in the 18th century, starting of 18th centuries. Okay. And later on stages, it was developed by different stages, and we are having different pendulums. This pendulum that has got from the outer magma, and this magnetic pendulum, and this glass pendulum which we can use it, and this is a semi-crystal pendulum, not complete crystal, semi-crystal pendulum. And this is a crystal pendulum. Okay. With all this other types of pendulum, even wood or any type of pendulum, magnetic pendulum, crystal pendulum gives you the exact prediction of these things. Okay. You can have the exact vibration has been got from this pendulum only. Okay. We know that crystal, when a small pressure is given to this crystal, magnetic energies are being evolved. Okay, the same thing is vice versa here. When a magnetic or flux lines are pulsed into it, we get vibrations. Okay, that is the best, that is why we get the best result in this one. I'll show you how to do it. Okay. See, this is a pendulum. Okay, we are seeing that for every thing, when we see that, we'll be getting 4 line of points. Okay, when we see here, we are seeing here it is a first point. Okay, here you are having the second point, here you are again having the third point, and this is your fourth point. Okay, I'll show and I'll see what is the difference between this points and how does it enumerate it. Okay, when we see a magnetic energy, it will be having magnetic lines. Okay, this is the first point which we saw, this is the second, this is the third, and this is the fourth. Okay, the maximum magnetic energy will be in this point, magnetic energy. Okay, or the flux lines. In the same way, when water is flowing at a point, this is the water. Water is flowing at the point. Due to this flow of water, there will be magnetic lines. Okay. This magnetic lines, when we see that, this is the first point, this is the second, third, and fourth. We have to find the first, exactly the midpoint using this pendulum. Okay. Next thing is, when we see this one, this is the surface and the depth of water should be calculated. Okay. To calculate the depth of this water, we are going for either Bishop rule, or we can ask yes or no to this pendulum and do it. I'll just demonstrate it how to do it. See, as we have seen that, this is the first point, that is the first location of your magnetic thing, and while coming to this point, you are getting the second one, and you are having the third one, and when we go apart from this, you are finding the fourth point. Okay, when we see that, the second, here it is your second point, and here is your third point. Okay, so your first energy is at this point, and your second energy is at your point. Okay, so you have to find a place which is middle to get your maximum wattage. Okay, this is the first part. Second, we are seeing that you have to find the depth. To find this depth, we are asking yes or no questions. Okay, three things has to be asked in it, whether it is a good water or not, Next one is how much water, that is the amount of water you will be getting it. And the third question should be the depth of the water level. Okay. For the first question, say, is it a good water or not? Say, it is a good water. If it is a bad water, it will be reversing it. Okay. So here it is a good water. You ask the first question, good water or not? It's a good water. Okay. Next one is you have to find the amount of water. So you are having, if it is above 1 inch, yes. If it is above 2 inch, no. See, it is reversing. If it is, we are again asking, if it is above 1 inch, yes. If it is above 1.5 inch, no. Again the answer is no. So it is above, is it above 1 inch? Yes, the water is above 1 inch. Okay. This one, third one is to find the depth of water. See, we are asking if it is above 100 feet. Yes, it is above 100 feet. If it is above 200 feet, no. If it is above 150 feet, it is no. Again, it reverses. So, if it is above 100 feet, okay. If it is above 110 feet, yes. 120 feet, yes. 130 feet, yes. 140, yes. 150, no. So, it is between 140 and 150 feet. Again, we are asking. If it is above 141 feet, 142 feet, 143. 144, no, it is 144 feet, the exact point where the water depth of water is 144 feet. This is how you use a pendulum for finding water, and the better result is got through this crystal pendulum.